So in this slide, I would like to discuss about evolution of sales representative. Sales representative are those persons who are responsible to sell certain product or services to the customer. They are the actual face of their own company. Sales representative are the real backbone of any organization, and total performance of a company majorly depends on sales representative of that particular company. Therefore, to improve their performance, continuous evaluation is needed so that the company can identify the loopholes and company can take the necessary action. Now, considering the evaluation of sales representative, there is two way we can evaluate a sales representative. Number one is general characteristics of sales representative, and number two is job performance of sales representative. Considering the general characteristics of sales representative, the first point which comes, that is accountability, means whether that particular person is fit for that job or not. The hiring management will evaluate the representative considering this particular point. The second one is interpersonal skill. To perform as a representative or sales representative of any company, the person should carry certain characteristics. Number one is smartness, number two is communication, number three is tactfulness, and other characteristics are also there considering the interpersonal skill. Therefore, considering the general characteristics of sales representative, this particular point is extremely important, and the hiring management or the manager will evaluate a sales representative depending on this interpersonal skill. The third one is organizational behavior. The sales representative must maintain an ethical behavior within the company as well as outside the company. This point is applicable for the internal environment of that company, also the external environment of that company. When the sales representative discusses something with his customer, he must maintain his ethical behavior. At the same time, when he is talking with his manager or any other persons of that company, the sales representative must maintain the ethical organizational behavior. Next point is regularity. In a sales profession, regularity is extremely important, because if you are irregular, automatically your competitor will get the advantage. So you have to be regular with your customer. You have to be regular in your company. It is extremely necessary. Considering the general characteristics of sales representative, last point is special contribution to the company. Considering the company perspective, company will never ask you about any special contribution, but it is your duty that you must add value to your performance. Special contribution is nothing but the value addition towards your own company. The next major part, which is job performance of sales representative. In this part, the first point is achievement of target. In sales profession, you'll have your monthly target. You may have your quarterly target, half yearly target, yearly target. Therefore, whether you are competent enough to achieve that target or not, or whether you have achieved it or not, that is the main concern considering this particular point. If you achieve that target, automatically you will get higher points. If you fail to achieve, then automatically you will get the lower point. Second is performance about the new product. In sales profession, always you will observe that on regular basis, the company will launch different types of product, and your performance will be evaluated depending on the performance about the new product, how the new products are working in your market. Third point is performance about the old product. You are working in an organization as a sales representative. Definitely, you'll have few old products under your portfolio. So what is the performance of those old products in your market? That shows your own activity inside the market. So that is another point. So your company will evaluate that particular point. And fourth one is maintenance of existing sales volume. Suppose you are working in a particular headquarter and you have a sales target monthly, maybe 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, or maybe 5 lakhs. That is the entire volume. So whether you are able to maintain that volume or not, that is also very much important. That is another factor. Next point is updated market knowledge. The hiring management will evaluate you depending on your updated knowledge. So for that purpose, they may take certain examination on regular basis, and they will judge your performance depending on your marks. Next point is new channel development. If you are working in a market and you are able to develop new marketing channel, that is one of the greatest contribution towards your company from you. So if you can develop new channel, that is advantageous towards your performance. And finally, the relationship with your customer. How you are maintaining the relationship with your customer, that is most important, and company will evaluate this particular point, and depending on that particular point, you will get some marks. So these are the total points